Hey everyone, VGC here, and welcome back to another episode of this lettering series. Still using the same term from yesterday, the Tapu-Fini Garchomp Kartana, Tapu Koko Porygon 2 and a Sirror. I'm going to find a 1595 rated Japanese player who is using a very interesting team of Smeargle, Crocodile, Whimsicott, Mudsdale, Honchkrow, which you never see, and a Celestilla. And the first thing I see is Tapu Fini puts in a lot of work, so I'm actually going to lead it. And I'm going to lead Tapu Fini Kartana with. I'm really leaning towards Incineroar in the back and like Porygon 2. Like, I don't want to just like lock it in that fast and then hope that then nothing goes awry, but it's like. It's honestly a really solid play. I'm gonna do that. Let's go for it. I don't like Coco in this game. But then he also has a Celestilla. I have white discerning. Let's go. I'm happy with this. And I don't like Garchomp in this game. It just doesn't do anything for me. He has two ground types. It's Intimidate. It's Intimidate weak. It just is not doing well. Oh, I just thought of something he could do. The Anger Point strategy. Anger Point? It's like an Anger Point team. Like a team meant to get crits. And then Shadow Thrashes. Kartana, Tapu Fini. Against Smeargle wins. Against one of the cut Smeargle's teams. So, there's like awful pressure from this. But I understand the main goal is to probably fake out. And I'm gonna taunt this Smeargle with Tapu Fini. Because I have the attack and it's honestly gonna do a lot of work. And I'm probably just going to Smart Strike the Whimsicott. Flinch. I'm going to get the taunt. And the Smeargle. So he can't. No Smart Shenanigans. It's a psychic type Z move. What is that Z Trick Room? I did not see that one coming. I did not see that coming. Like from a mile away. I'm just gonna taunt the Whimsicott. And I brought my Trick Room Pokemon in the back. Mostly the Portland teams in work place, so I'm gonna switch in Porygon 2 over Kartana, because Kartana's speed is always gonna be a very much of a clutch. A crutch for Kartana, I don't like. Let's see what he does. Get the attack increase. Whimsicott protects. Explosion? What is this team? What? Oh my gosh, what is this team? Smeargle just immediately KO'd himself? What am I saying? I'm very confused. This is one of the most interesting games I've ever played. He brings in Mudsdale. Oh my gosh, I feel like he might beat up. That was a Z-Jerker. I'm gonna taunt the Whims. And I'm gonna ice beam the Mudsdale slot. Taunt the Whimsicott, ice beam the Mudsdale. It might just be in a. He already used his Z-move, so I don't have to worry about anything. Like a. He goes for Swagger. What is his team? Oh my gosh. And he's gonna go for an EQ. I just lost because I have no idea what I'm expecting. Let me get the Ice Beam into Mudsdale. Bring in a Incineroar fake out and try to reverse Trick Room? Is that a play that I want to make? And then taunt just kind of messes all that up. Wait, I don't know what I'm expecting. Fake out the Mudsdale and try to reverse Trick Room because this is actually a pretty decent play. Honestly, this is like what I need to do legit. And then he could reverse Nigga Trick Room. He's switching the South Dillon. Alright. Oh, this is fun. He predicted my reversing Trick Room. And then he's gonna get 5-4 turn to abuse it. That was fun. That accomplished a lot. Like, jokingly aside, that accomplished a lot. Flare Blitz, Ice Man, the Whimsicott. And he can just bring in Horse. In his own, but still. At least there's one more turn of this. Celesteel is not touching the ground, so it will be confused, but he probably have a Lumbear or Persevere. Exactly. Lumbear. Whimsicott finally goes down. It means such a pain to deal with. And, well, I actually won this game. I have a chance. But this game was something else. I have no idea what to expect. I don't even know how it won. I'm being serious. I have no idea how I won. If I win this game, I have no idea how. Like, Smeargle exploded. When the guy went down, yeah, I got a double knockout this turn. I have Carton in the back, so it's literally Leaf Blade and KO it. Wait, Darkest Lariat, Ice Beam is my best play. Wait, my opponent means be out, but it's like... Alright. And if I win this game, it's literally because of the Cartana Leaf Blade. And Sash Cartana. Oh, Cartana isn't sashed anymore. I might lose. It depends what he has in the back. I might lose. I thought Cartana was sashed. But I have to worry about Cartana's natural bow to kind of hang on. Is there any point in stalling out Trick Room turns? I need to stall out Trick Room, so I'm going to click Protect. If he goes for something like a Substitute, or like if Mustard gets a recovery move, I have no idea about. If he goes for CC, does that knock out? I'm at no bulk. I'll probably never get a chance again. I need to solo protect and then hope. I need to go for double protect. Solo protect the Trick Room. It fails. It's not that close combat. I don't know what to expect though. That was weird. I don't know that game. That was weird. That game was out of hand. But I got it closed, and that one still was such a problem. And I'm going to say I don't know what happened, but that was interesting. My opponent gave me an awesome thumbnail of a Smeargle exploding. I have never thought in a billion years that that would be a thing. We're gonna go into our next battle and hope that everything is punky dory. I don't know what to expect. I have like no words. $14.87 Japanese Hurting Player. Using Neelago, Cartana, Garchomp, Arcanine, Tapu Fini, and Tapu Koko. We're using a lot of the similar Pokemon. He has a Kartana, I have a Garchomp, Arcanine. We're using four of the same six, and the fifth roll is very similar. Until where Kartana, Garchomp is actually a pretty decent lead option. But wait, Kartana and Cinnaroar with Coco, Porygon 2, I'm thinking. I wish Kartana had his Focus Action Game 1, that would have been really good. Is that the best one? No wait. Kartana, Coco. Yep. That's honestly same thing but better. And we're gonna see what he leads. I have no idea about that game one. That game one's weird. That first game of this video was weird. And I will say that. Arcanine Garchomp. What's my play? That's not a Scarf Chomp. That's not a Scarf Chomp mostly because I don't predict that you would bring a Scarf Garchomp next to a Arcanine. That would mostly go for Earthquake. I don't believe that's something that most people do. I do believe in going for a Leaf Blade plus Thunderbolt into the Arcanine slot is the best. Yeah, let's go for that. Nope, go for a Dazzling Gleam so I can pick a double KO if. Depending on what he does. Not if Garchomp protects. I'm gonna pick the KO Garchomp. And Kartana reflexes attack that with the VGC's ability. And he goes for a Snarl. Also supportive Arcanine. I'm glad that I know that, at least in this game. Supportive Arcanine, Flare Blitz. I don't have to worry about extreme speed, so it has at least one supportive move in the Flare Blitz. The pit. Now the main goal I want to get from this is the scout. Does he have any more? Top Club will switch in, so Protect. Top Coco switches in the Porygon too. It had Garchomp that would be worth it to the future. But I don't have any Cinnaroar, because Cinnaroar is good. Cinnaroar is good, it's does this job well. And I get a special attack increase, which is sick. He has Heat Wave. Well, he has a Spread Attack. Sacred Sword and Trick Room. I believe this game is going to be won by a hard Trick Room right now. He has Heat Wave, so he might have Roar. Almost knocks out. I predicted Kartana was the same, because I thought he was going for Heat Wave. So I'm really just going to Sacred Sword of Kartana and recover. I actually have an idea. I'm gonna go for it, because I actually really see it as a viable play if he's gonna go for it. If he's gonna spam Heat Wave. What if I am just gonna go off of this? What if I let him kind of switch out? And then I trick him. Like, reverse the trick room. And then protect Coco. And use the trick room with Porygon 2 as more of a deterrent. Kind of like to stop his potential switching. Like, you know, kind of just neuter it. If that makes sense. Like, none of this makes sense, but it makes sense in my head. Like, I use trick room as more of with Porygon 2 as more of an annoyance for my phone. You think so? I'm pretty cool. He went for Snarl. I used Trick Room as more of a deterrent against his strategies. And now I can Thunderbolt the Arcanine. Pick up a lot of damage on that. And Thunderbolt the top of Phoenix Fly. This all makes sense in my head, which is why I'm saying it out loud. If that makes sense. It probably doesn't. I'm going to double into the Arcanine. I'm going to triple Thunderbolt the Arcanine. Double Thunderbolt the Arcanine. He switches out Freddy, so in the Cartana, so I'm gonna get two terrain moved at T-Bolt. It paralyzed. That's perfect. Can I get a full pair? That would be really cool. Yes, Coco avoided. Important to getting weakened. And I can easily just click Deagling. I'm gonna easily click Deagling. T-Bolt. Cartana goes down. Can I get a Paralyze? A free pair. See, the trigger worked, and I get a crit. That was terrific. And the trigger worked exactly where I'm going. Which kind of shows, which I'm kind of happy for, because I feel like I'm getting better with playing trigger with this style of team. Where I have more of a possible mode with it, and I'm probably just gonna switch Porygon to it. Actually, I'm gonna switch out. Actually, I just want to get a terrain boost this Thunderbolt. I'm gonna accept that Incineroar did its job, and I'm gonna go for T-Bolt, see how much damage that does. I'm curious. And he just four hits. And that was a win. And I really might get one more. Mostly because I have time. And we're only 18 minutes and I don't want to upload a short video for you guys. That's not fun for me. And plus, I'm feeling really confident. I'm going to click it. Nope. Come on, Guardian 80 song, because I like it. Vincent 1647 California. He's using a ring team. So ring team, Pelipper Golduck, Bulu, Metagross, and not Incineroar. Incineroar and whatchamacallit? Buzzwole. I could not say Buzzwole. I like Finny. I'm trying to think what I like. I'm going to lock in the four Pokemon I actually want to bring. I like Finny Cartana as the lead. And I like Porygon 2. And I don't like Incineroar. Actually, I like it in a sense. That's weird. I like it in another. I like it because it said, I like it dark typing in its game. I like that more. Because his team seems to rely on that rain. I like his dark type, and that's what I really like. The rest of it can... I like his dark type, because Metagross, honestly... I can see Metagross in more of a... I feel safe mode, but it's kind of just real wrong with that. And plus, it's assault vest and protecting the kids. It's assault vest, so I trust Mr. Roy. We're gonna see what he does. We'll see what he does. I'm legitimately curious. I'm gonna see Pokemon trainer Vincent. And he leads Pelipper Metagross. Incineroar would actually be a decent lead. It would have been better than I expected, honestly. Pelipper is gonna kill them. But yeah, Metagross can be deer mashing. That is a threat. So I'm gonna muddy water. I'm gonna go for a muddy water. And I'm gonna leaf blade the Pelipper. I don't see a switch in for this, like. You can bring in finish, you can bring in Buzzwool, sure. Actually, and then by the pool, they would honestly be one of the best switch-ins from my opponent. I'm just kind of looking at it. And connect with the muddy water. That's a really slow lead, I'm saying. Oh, that almost knocked out. He didn't go for a then headbutt. And a Kartana. And is he gonna tail him? Yeah, that's a really slow Pelipper. I'm just gonna click Muddy Water and I'm gonna protect. Do I have Pizza in the back? I do, so Trick Room is gonna be really fun. I'm gonna protect with him, Carton. And he'll probably go for a Meteor Mash, right? Like, I can see a Beauty or Match Brian play. Pelipper protects. We'll see what he does. Heals for the Zen Headbutt. Into Finny. Can I not this? Yes, I not this. Can I get an accuracy drop? I don't get anything I want. My Pokemon isn't big enough to do what I want. Muddy water, and I'll just quickly split. Yeah, I get like a switch, a miss or something, that would be pretty clutch. Then headbutt. No, I don't even get a low card. I got a crit. That's like unnecessary. I'm gonna switch in Porygon too, and I'm trying to see how legit I am with sacking. I'm bringing in Golduck. This is probably like my last chance. I really want to speed up. I really want a special attack boost. Yes, I get a special attack boost. I saw it coming from like a mile away. So I was so happy. Trick Room. Leaf Blade. Ice Beam and a Kartana. Kartana goes down. And this off the head did a big amount of damage with that thin headbutt. Does about half. Tailwind Tailwind peers out. What's the play? The play is to fake out the Metagross and... Actually, what's the real play, honestly? Give Wooloo.
Let me turn it to rain and well. Some more.
T-Bolt Snarl is honestly a decent play. Like, Metagross is pretty fast looking, and, Aaron's Metagross, which, if my computer will look right, I can look at that speed. Metagross switches out. Into Blue. Gold up attacks. And the rain stops, so he didn't rank Incineroar nor did he rank his Buzzwill. And I'm not in position of restricted right now. We are not at that point.
T-Bolt.
And I'm gonna Darkest Lariat. The Golduck Claw. That Golduck is the biggest threat. It just picks up an alright KO. I did not expect that. That's why I won't try to track it so yet. It's okay damage, I guess. And it glitches. And the Sport Rapture. I'm gonna Flare Blitz the Blue. I'm gonna flip with the blue and go for a, whatchamacallit. Flip with the blue, Ice Beam the Metagross. And how many times do I have to try to win this game? I have two. So, Beam the Gross. I got a special attack increase, right? Exactly. Flip with the blue. Alright, cool. Almost knocks out. But I'm gonna get a free flow boots. And I'm just gonna blow up that blue. And Incineroar just came through. Incineroar just came through and I like it for that. I'm gonna go for a Darkest Lariat mostly because I like the animation. I'm gonna recover. Recover with Porygon 2 just in case he decides to do anything else. Recover and Lariat the Metagross slot, and he just clicked forfeit. So that's really cool. So we picked up two wins in this battle. The first one, the second one was into Rain team, and Rain is actually pretty cool. Like, my Rain matchup with this team is a little bit awkward. Like, honestly, I think in general Rain situation with this team, I generally like the Brainiest Pokemon. Like, bring my Arcanine, well, not Arcanine, Incineroar, Talvini, and Kartana with Porygon 2. Mostly because, like, against most Rain teams, this seems like the best solution. So yeah, Talvini, Rain. Kartana is super effective attacks with the Leaf Blade and Smart Strike. Take Sword on live damage. Finny's Water Typing and Incineroar Bulk if I can get a Patricrum. And pouring onto just offensive pressure because there was T-Bolt. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. See you guys tomorrow.